I chose full-time because I'm the type of person that likes to do things more intensely.
Because I am looking at furthering my education and obtaining my master's degree in nursing, and I would like to do it before I get older.
I thought it would just be better to get in and work through it and complete it in 1 year.
Because I want to finish and get my Bachelor of Nursing within 1 year. And later on, I would like to get my master degree in nursing as well.
I wanted to study for my NCLEX, and part-time was the only option for the fall.
I chose part-time due to my family and work commitments.
I chose part-time because I graduated in June and needed to study for my NCLEX. I didn't think I could handle full-time study for the NCLEX and full-time classes during the summer.
I work as an on-call. Sometimes they call me once a week, sometimes I work 3 times a week.
Right now, I am a wife, a mother, got a house, I've got a home business, but I'm not working as an RN currently.
I was fortunate to start working for a hospital, and I work 40 to 44 hours per week.
The first year I did not work, and the second year, this year, I got a residency, and thankfully I took 4 credits and was able to manage the 4 credits while doing the residency in a new position.
I do work, and I work 40 plus hours a week.
I currently work 3 days a week, every weekend, 12-hour shifts, full-time.
How many hours do I study per week outside of class? I would say an average of 20 to 30 hours a week.
Probably 2-3 hours per class.
Anywhere from 12 to 16 hours per week.
The average they say is 2 hours outside for every 1 credit. Yeah, I probably do more than that, at least that.
I would say on an average week, I study between 12 and 16 hours.
10 to 15 hours, depending on the quarter. I've had quarters that have been a little bit more busy than others.
The advantages of being full-time for me is that I can finish my school early, and then afterwards I can focus with my work.
Because you're fully delved into the program, you're more current with what's going on. And I'm in that school mode, school mindset.
You meet a lot of people, you're on campus more often, you have more opportunities for networking and resources.
If you have other goals, such as furthering your education, you can get started on those goals at a sooner time versus waiting later on in life.
The advantage of part-time is that you can get your electives done and still have a life if you want to.
The schedule is manageable for me due to my outside commitments.
I can complete my major and my minor in the shortest amount of time possible, especially because I want to become a doctorate nurse practitioner, and a bachelor's degree is required.
My strategies to succeed: I spend a lot of time studying. I really put in the hours, and I hated group work when I started, but I'll tell you, group work has really done a lot for me.
Just to make sure that I stay focused, but also take time for myself to stay healthy.
Taking advantage of those weeks that you have less work to work ahead, so the weeks that you are swamped and you can manage and be successful.
So prioritizing and having things set in that order in my head is what really helps me succeed.
If I had any advice for students to pick part-time or full-time, I'd say really evaluate your life. Do you have children? Is it important for you to work? Is there a way you can not work or work part-time and get your education in, because it's really a good program?
Between choosing full-time or part-time, that's definitely a personal choice. It depends how your life is set up and how much you can manage. And I live with my family, so I don't have to take care of kids or anything like that. I imagine it would be much more difficult. If you have lots of other stuff going on with your life, I probably would not recommend a full-time, because you might end up burning out.